word work is used three times of God in Genesis chapter 2. Secondly, in Genesis 1, 26, 28, I have looked at that so many times you think I'd have memorized by now, but I don't. 26, 28 says God made man and women, amen, in his image. All right, both. Let me read this. And listen for the pronouns here. Then God said, let us. Who's the us? Trinity. Interesting. Let us make man in our image, in our likeness. There it is again. It says it three times because you got the Father, you got the Son before he came, before he was born as Jesus. All right, on Christmas, right? Let us make man in our image, in our likeness. Let them rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air, livestock, over all the earth, over all the creatures that move along the ground. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. And then he gives this blessing here in verse 28. God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful and increase in number. That's why they needed men and women, right? Fill the earth and subdue it. Rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air and every living creature that moves on the ground. So as there was this multiplying, filling, subduing, ruling thing that was both a blessing and a command. So he basically calls them to be his co-workers. Because even though he created everything perfect, it wasn't complete. It had potential. It had gold in the ground that needed to come out. It had trees that needed to be knocked down and sawn into wood and made furniture and rocks to be turned into statues. And eventually, you know, finding out the stuff that we see all around us, it comes from the ground or it comes from stuff that we made from the ground. So it's amazing. So the idea of ruling and co-subduing, being a co-worker with God. And that's just mind-blowing to think about that. So that's Genesis 1:28 referred to as the cultural or creation mandate. All right, command and a blessing. Adam and Eve to do it together with God, to multiply, fill the earth, and rule over it. And I like what Dr. Whitmer, my professor, says. God created Adam and Eve in his image, empowering them to expand the boundary of Eden until the entire world flourished under their loving care. And if you think about it, when God made the earth and spoke it into being, he did two things. He created something from nothing. And he created order from chaos. So whenever we work, and I know when you're doing a research paper, you got 16 books out in front of you, and you got your computer up, and you got your notes, and your brain's going 8 million directions, and you're bringing order out of chaos, and you're putting it in a logical sequence. And sometimes you start with a blank piece of paper, so you're really creating something from nothing. So it's not that we are God, but we are God's co-worker, and we are like God because we are made in his image to be a worker, to do those things.